A crowd gathered in Chinubi village, Hoima East Division, when a 14-year-old Daphne Chimuli's lifeless body was discovered hanging from a tree on Wednesday morning. Chimuli, who scored aggregate 28 in her primary leaving examinations, which she sat at Buikia Muslim Primary School in Hoima City, committed suicide. In a note she reportedly left behind, she accused a neighbor and teacher, Madame Jessica, as well as her peers, of constantly harassing her over her performance in the exams.
Why can I stay alive when I'm learning badly? They talk about me, I don't want.
We found out Daphne had left a letter behind mentioning about her enemies. She was also talking about the poor performance and people have been laughing at her.
Could the constant torment Chimuli was subjected to over the 5 days since she received her results have triggered a lack of self-worth? According to Paul Waluya, a counseling psychologist at Break Free Teen Rehab, many children are struggling with meeting expectations of those under whose care they are.
There are many demands or a lot of expectations from the parents. You know, they put examples, they put limits, they put role models whereby this child may not be able to stretch up to that level. So when this child is not able to stretch up to that level, you find that the parent is, he finds himself, is disappointed in the child. Then he's also going to throw a lot of words to show his anger to why you didn't make it to the levels I wanted. Maybe I've already invested a lot of money in you, I put coaching, I've done this, I've taken you there, I've taken you there, and he's showing that kind of anger toward this person. And then of course these words that we mention, they don't just fall anywhere, they fall into this person's mind, this person's emotions, you know. Then they trigger negative emotions. No, I think my parent does not love me, I think I'm worthless.
With aggregate 28, which put her in Division 3, Daphne had not failed, according to the National Exam Board. But where do these education expectations that every student has to pass in Division 1 stem from?
The deceptive publication about release of exams, deceptive and sensational publication by media, by private schools, and some government-aided schools. You have wrongly shaped the public opinion about education. There is no need whatsoever why even results should be published in papers with that too much hype. The stakeholders at policy-making level, that is the ministry, they have failed to streamline the education sector. Schools are opening as early as 4 a.m. Children wake up as early as 4 a.m. in the morning. They leave school as late as 9 p.m., 10 p.m. All of that time, you are pumping students because you are looking for grades.
Waluya and Chibuka agree that high grades are not what define the path of success in life. They have implored parents to sit with their children and guide them on their options while assuring them that they are not defined by grades, but their passions and unique abilities.
Grades don't identify the person, but we should look at a person holistically, you know, instead of looking at the academic arena only. Maybe he has not performed well, he has gotten a 22, a 20 what, then you say this person is not bright or brilliant enough. It's not enough. I mean, that's not life. That is just a component of life.
If you believe that someone who scores aggregate 4 is some sort of king or queen, then you've got to change that. So I would advise parents that let them not be demoralized by those grades. You should have identified the abilities of your child so that you are able to place him or her appropriately. We have vocational education, we have technical education, we have classical education. This classical education, which is producing grades, that is classical curriculum.
Every child has been created with a different gift. Do take the time to nurture the one yours has been given. Rita Kanya, NTV News.